What's up, YouTube fam? Brandon Weaver here once again, and today we are talking about the method of verification. The method of verification and how they're not supposed to use EOSCR and how you can go ahead and circumvent that and have them not utilize that. We're also talking about somebody boosting up their credit score, had to take somebody to court. But hey, let's talk about it, okay? Let's talk about small claims. Let's talk about this right now. Okay, so I got an email, and actually, sorry, this is YouTube comments, all right? So I'll be reading the YouTube comments, get to the YouTube comments. You can put some YouTube comments below. Let me know how good things are going for you, where your credit score is heading, what you want to get, what you're doing, and if you're part of the subscribe tribe, I appreciate you. Now, this individual said, hey, they sent a couple of letters out. They didn't get back any verification. So they went out, reached out to the credit bureau, and they asked for their method of verification. Hey, they would say, you're not sending any proof, no validation, no verification. How are you guys verifying this? They came back, they literally said they're using the EOSCR system. They told them this. Why? Why would they tell them? Because they have to divulge in their process and their processes to you. That's what we request in the method of verification letters. It's part of the 609 Credit Repair series. You get it on 609creditrepair.com and we can do it for you. We know the process. We find the violations. We can help you out. Okay? So what we've got here is a demand for a credit bureau and investigation. All right? Now, you submit all this good stuff with your account numbers to the bureau you need. Right in here, if you haven't known already, if you haven't been on my live streams, hit the bell for notifications, the subscribe button, hit the subscribe button, then the bell, so you get this, because we've talked about this on the live stream, so this is what you were talking about, okay? If you had done an investigation properly, rather than use your EOSCR system, you go ahead and call them out, you let them know. Now, it gets better, watch. So, they know that you know, and you're gonna show them why it's so important that you know. You would have known that this account, right? You would have known there was improper verification or validation for this account had you done a proper investigation, okay? It's fantastic. Now, this is where we get into the nitty gritty. So they say, hey, look, your company, right? Your company's claiming this. You would have known that it's not verified, right? If you use the EOSCR system, they say, hey, we already told you. Yeah, 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 you told me, but what you don't know is I know. That Cushman versus TransUnion, okay? Stephenson versus Experian, Richardson versus Equifax, okay? All the courts, each and every time, they came back and they said that the credit bureaus cannot merely parrot information from the creditors and collectors. They have to do and conduct a reasonable investigation on their own, which means they can't just use the EOSCR system. This is not considered reasonable. Great, okay, fantastic. That's what I'm talking about. This is the issue, is they will come back and parrot and they'll say, well, we don't know, we got it from the collector, we got it from the creditor, and they say, and so we can just say no. And we know the case law, and so it goes on, okay? This letter is fantastic. If you do not initiate an investigation regarding my dispute under the Fair Credit Reporting Act, I will have to take some legal action, okay? I'm sure you're aware, Fair Credit Reporting Act allows damages up to $1,000 per each violation. Yes? Now we know that. We know that if you haven't subscribed already, hit that button for bell for notifications, then you want to, because you want to know this information, be able to talk to me on these live streams. Now, I got another email in from another awesome, awesome customer doing it themselves. They walked in, they got a little help, small claims, they had done all the stuff, okay, CFPB, all this good stuff. They got a bunch of other negative items off. The score was going up, okay? I keep getting nice emails, their score was going up, but one lingering deal. So they go to small claims. Sure enough, the attorney on the other side, the other collector, they call them up, they say, you know, we want to settle, you know, we'll go ahead and delete this for you, let's figure this out, right? They're calling her, saying, now they're on the defense. This is what happens, we keep pushing back. People are getting deletions, okay? People are getting stuff removed, nasty, negative things, all right? Had somebody said, this is Global, all right? Global says, hey, gotten a few items deleted. However, someone came back and they're just sending a bill, all right? So Global, thank you so much for leaving the comment. They're just sending the bill. They're not sending the full arrangement, the contract, okay? And let me tell you guys, the contract will say, it'll have to have your signature on it. It'll have to say that third parties are allowed to have your information, that you sign off on it. Believe me, these contracts exist out there, but they don't have them. Nobody's got this stuff, and they're not showing you guys this stuff, okay? It doesn't exist, doesn't have it, no more, so it's not your debt, all right? It's not supposed to be verified and on there, okay? So, I get pumped up, all right? You can send the collection validation letter and you can send your complaints in the CFPB. You can send the 609 letters. You can get them at 609creditrepair.com. These nasty negative items come off. Your credit score can go up. You put the primary trade lines on there. I get excited about it. You can email me for all your needs and concerns with credit repair. And until I see you in person, I will see you on the other side. Take care.